Welcome all of you in online teaching learning process. We have started unit number 2, metal ligand bonding in transition metal complexes, and in our last video we have seen details about the molecular orbital theory, the different parts to form molecular orbital diagrams from atomic orbitals of metal and ligand group orbitals. And in this video we will see details about the molecular orbital theory or details about the formation of octahedral complexes based on the molecular orbital theory. We very well know that molecular orbital theory first proposed by which scientist, that is Hund and Mulliken discovered this theory, so this is called as molecular orbital theory. Then also we have studied that molecular orbital theory, that is in molecular orbital theory, treats the whole molecule as a single polycentric nucleus, as like this diagram, single polycentric nucleus. The molecular orbital are constructed by the combination of atomic orbitals on metal and ligands by the linear combination of atomic orbital method, and bonding comes into play in the complex compounds. So this is the general arrangement of molecular orbital diagrams. So here is a ligand group orbitals, and in this side there is a metal atomic orbitals. When metal atomic orbital and ligand group orbital combine, we are getting molecular orbitals at the middle part. So lowest energy orbital is A1g, then T1u, then Eg, then T2g, then Eg star, A1g star and T1u star. Out of them, these are the bonding molecular orbital. T2g is a non-bonding, and these star are called as antibonding molecular orbital. So this is the basic about the molecular orbital diagrams. Then we will see application of molecular orbital theory in the formation of octahedral complexes, and out of them we will see formation of hexa aqua titanium third ion. Then the formula is, that is titanium H2O6 3+, that is hexa aqua titanium 3+ ion, and in this case the complex is called as D1 complex because d orbital contains only one electron, so this is a D1 complex. Then in this case we will see formation of molecular orbital diagram for titanium H2O6 3+. Initially we know that titanium having atomic number, that is atomic number of titanium is 22. Then ground state electronic configuration is represented as argon 3d2 4s2. But in the case of titanium H2O6 3+, titanium shows 3+ oxidation state. So in the titanium 3+ ion, electronic configuration becomes to argon 3d1 4s0. So in the case of titanium H2O6 3+ ion, there are 13 electrons present. How these are 13 electrons will be formed? That is 12 electrons coming from water molecules, because there are 6 water molecules, so each ligand contribute 2 electrons, so 6 water molecules contribute 12 electrons, and 1 electron coming from titanium 3+ ion from this electronic configuration. Titanium 3+ ion contain only 1 electron, so it contribute 1 electron. So total electron present in titanium H2O6 3+ ion is 12 + 1, that is 13 electrons present. And this is the general arrangement of molecular orbital diagram as we have discussed in previous slide. So in the case of molecular orbital diagram, that is the overall, in case of titanium H2O6 3+, there are 13 electrons and may be distributed according to a Bose principle, that is lower energy first then higher energy. Then the 12 electrons coming from ligands will occupy the low energy bonding molecular orbitals in the order A1g, T1u, Eg. So in this case, out of 13 electrons, 12 electrons coming from ligand group orbitals. So this is the ligand group orbitals, and so this ligand group orbitals, that is how many electrons present in ligand group orbital? 12 electrons, and this 12 electrons goes into the lower energy orbitals. That is, 2 electrons occupied by A1G, then 6 electrons occupied by T1U. Then 4 electrons occupied by EG orbital. So all the ligand group orbitals are goes into the bonding molecular orbital. So this is the bonding molecular orbitals. Then the last electron coming from titanium 3 plus ion will then occupy the next higher energy orbital, that is one of the T2G molecular orbital. Then in the case of metal, that is metal contains only one electron, and this one electron goes into the T2G orbital. So this is a non-bonding molecular orbital. So one electron goes into the T2G orbital, which is a higher energy than bonding molecular orbitals. So this is the general electronic arrangement or molecular orbital diagram of titanium H2O6 3+, that is hexa-aqua titanium 3+ ion. This is the molecular orbital diagram. In exam they will ask, write a note on molecular orbital diagram of MOT of hexa-aqua titanium 3+ ion. Then this diagram is very essential. In this diagram, the arrangement is, that is, atomic orbitals of titanium 3+ ion at left side, and ligand group orbitals of 6 water molecules present at the right side, and the middle part is a molecular orbitals of titanium H2O6 3+, and it is divided into bonding molecular orbital at lower energy, then non-bonding at the middle part, and antibonding at the upper level. So this is the general arrangement of molecular orbital diagrams. So in the case of only titanium H2O6 3+, one electron is present in titanium 3+, that is one electron in present in metal, one electron coming from metal, and 12 electrons coming from ligand group orbitals. So in this case, that is, one electron finally goes into the T2G non-bonding orbitals, and EG star orbitals are MT1, and the gap between T2G and EG star is very small because water is a weak field ligand. So in this case, very small gap, and one electron goes into the T2G orbital. So this is the basic about the titanium H2O6 3+ ion. Then next we will see, thus there is only one electron, unpaired electron, present in titanium H2O6 3+ ion, which accounts for its weak paramagnetic character, because only one unpaired electron is present, so it is a weakly paramagnetic nature. So in this case, another terminology, that is HOMO. HOMO means highest occupied molecular orbital, and from this diagram, HOMO is a 3 T2G orbitals. Highest occupied, that is, first electron goes into the A1G, then T1U, then EG, and last into the T2GN. So this is called as HOMO. So this is called as highest occupied molecular orbital. And next level is a LUMO, lowest unoccupied molecular orbital, that is 2EG star orbital. That is, after that, filled one, unoccupied level is EG star, so it is called as LUMO. In exam or in MS entrance exam, they will ask, in titanium H2O6 3+ ion, which of the following is the HOMO, or which of the following is the LUMO orbital? Then HOMO orbitals are T2GN, and LUMO orbitals are EG star. LUMO means MT1, and HOMO means last filled one. So this is the basic about the molecular orbital diagram of titanium H2O6 3+. Then next level we will see how to calculate CFC value, crystal field stabilization value, for titanium H2O6 3+. Then we know that in case of octahedral complex, CFC calculated by using the formula 0.4 times number of electrons in T2G, that is X electron, plus 0.6 times number of electrons in EG, that is Y electrons, into multiply by delta O plus Z pairing energy. So in the case of titanium H2O6 3+ ion, that is, in this case, there is a one electron present in T2G orbital and 0 electrons present in EG orbitals. So in this case, CFC is equal to minus 0.4 times 1 electron plus 0.6 times 0 electron plus there is no pairing, so 0 pairing. So overall minus 0.4 times delta O, delta octahedral value. But in the case of titanium H2O6 3 plus, it absorbs the light near about 500 nanometer. So absorption maximum is near about 20,000 centimeter inverse. So this is the absorption maximum value for titanium H2O6 3 plus, that is delta O value 20,000 centimeter. By using this formula, minus 0.4 multiply by 20,000, we are getting minus 8,000 centimeter inverse. So this is the CFSC value for titanium H2O6 3 plus. For MSc entrance purpose, this question will be asked. That is, what is the CFSC value for titanium H2O6 3 plus when, that is, the titanium H2O6 3 plus shows absorption maximum T2DT transition is 20,000 centimeter inverse, then CFSC is, such type of question will be asked. So answer is minus 8,000 centimeter inverse. Then electronic configuration of titanium H2O6 3 plus ion is, overall electronic configuration is from low energy to high energy. That is, first electron goes into the A1G, then T1U, then EG, then T2G, and there is no electrons in EG star. So electronic configuration is A1G 2, T1U 6, EG 4, T2G 1, and EG star. So this is the overall electronic configuration of titanium H2O6 3 plus ion. Then next we will see some of the significance of delta O value and its physical measurements. So electronic spectrum titanium H2O6 3 plus. So in this case, titanium is surrounded by how many ligands? 6 water ligands. So in this case, one electron is present in T2G lobe and EG orbitals are empty, as we have seen in previous slide. So in this case, when titanium H2O6 3 plus ion absorbs that light near about 494 nanometer inverse, or near about 20,300 centimeter inverse, or near about 20,000 centimeter inverse, then the electron is transferred or ejected by absorption of light. Electron is ejected from T2G orbital to EG orbital, from lower level to higher level, and due to this excitation, the color of the complex becomes to purple color. So this color appear in the case of titanium H2O6 3 plus. When we form the complex, then the color of the complex is a purple colored, because this color is arises due to the absorption of this type of radiation, 494 nanometer or 20,300 centimeter inverse radiations. So in the case of, previously we have studied it, titanium H2O6 3 plus CFSC value we have calculated minus 8,000 centimeter inverse. So in this slide only we want to know that is when light of 510 or 500 nanometer inverse absorbed, one electron transferred from T2G to EG orbital. So one electron excitation takes place, and electronic configuration T2G 1 EG 0 to T2G 0 EG 1. When light absorbed, then excitation of electron is possible. So in this case, because the sample absorbs most strongly around the green region, that is 500 nanometer in region of the visible spectrum, and it appears purple color, complementary color will be formed. So in the case of color of complex, color of titanium H2O6 3 plus ion, when incoming lambda, that is absorption of light from visible region, takes place, then this T2G electron after absorption excited, electron jump to higher level, and this is responsible to give purple color to titanium H2O6 3 plus ion. So green yellow light is absorbed as an electron is promoted from one set of d orbital to the other set of d orbital. So overall this process is called as DD transition. In MSc entrance we will ask, titanium H2O6 3 plus ion shows color due to which, that is DD transition. Due to DD transition, this complex shows color, and the color is which type of color? That is a purple color is formed, sir. दैट इज अनदर क्वेश्चन अराइजेस, द कलर ऑफ टिटेनियम इज 2+6+3+ इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग, दैट इज अ पर्पल कलर. सो ओवरऑल वी हैव स्टडीड इट, दैट इज पर्पल कलर इज फॉर्मड इन टिटेनियम इज 2+6+3+ ड्यू टू द एक्साइटेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम T2G टू EG ऑर्बिट. सो दिस इज ओवरऑल अबाउट द मोलिकुलर ऑर्बिटल डायग्राम ऑफ टिटेनियम इज 2+6+3+ आयन. सो थैंक यू ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर लिसनिंग दिस वीडियो.